I love you, Allah.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man sama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbihi. Wa man qama Ramadan imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbihi. Wa man qama Laylatul Qadr imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbihi." Three things he said. Any one of them will forgive all of your sins. All. Unconditional. No matter what sin you have done, if you repent properly in this month and you do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to do and what the Prophet ﷺ told us to do, all of your sins will be forgiven. What are these three things he said? Whoever fasts the entire month of Ramadan, believing in Allah and hoping for Allah's reward. Those are the only two conditions. That you are a believer in Allah and you do the fast wanting the rewards from Allah. You're doing it expecting Allah to reward you. You're not doing it because society is doing it. You're not doing it because your parents want you to do it. You're not doing it because all of your friends are doing it. You're not doing it because the culture of your country requires you to do it. You're doing it for the sake of Allah. You're doing it purely to please Allah. If you did it with this intention, the Prophet ﷺ said, all of your previous sins are forgiven. The second thing he said, whoever stands up at night in Ramadan. And Ramadan has a beautiful prayer that we call Taraweeh. This prayer is a prayer that is the equivalent of the tahajjud of the other nights. In Ramadan we call it Taraweeh, it is the same prayer. This prayer is a prayer that the Prophet ﷺ did occasionally and the Sahaba also did, and it is something that he did it in congregation occasionally and he did it at his home all the time. And so in our times, it has become a congregational prayer that is encouraged to do. You are encouraged to pray Taraweeh. It is not obligatory, but you are encouraged to do so. And if you do so every single night, if you do so, then that is one more opportunity to have all of your sins forgiven. And the third opportunity to have all of your sins forgiven is the opportunity known as Laylatul Qadr. And what will make you understand what Laylatul Qadr is? It is one night of Ramadan. It is one night of Ramadan that when you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala properly, when you are standing in prayer and reading Quran and doing dhikr for this one night, then all of your previous sins will be forgiven. This is Laylatul Qadr. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us three opportunities in this month to get all of our sins forgiven. One more blessing of Ramadan. Ramadan is the month that when you perfect your fasting in it, you may enter Jannah by a special door. It is a special door set aside for those who fast. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in Jannah there is a special door called Ar-Rayyan. Ar-Rayyan. And Ar-Rayyan means that which will give you lots of water. So it is called that which will give you water because the way to get to it is to deprive yourself of water. How so? The Prophet ﷺ said, it is set aside for those who fast frequently, for those who perfect their fast. And you cannot perfect your fast until you have perfected the fast of Ramadan. So fasting Ramadan forgives your sins. Fasting Ramadan causes you to enter Jannah. Fasting Ramadan brings about a sense of taqwa and iman. Remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O you who believe, fasting has been made obligatory upon you as it was made on those before you, so that you may achieve righteousness and piety. So remember that the purpose of fasting Ramadan is to achieve righteousness and piety.